Hello viewers, myself is Dr. Neeta and you are watching my channel Learn Literature with Dr. Neeta. So let us begin today's topic. Hello dear students, today we would learn about Sir Philip Sidney's views on drama as these have been depicted in his famous work An Apology for Poetry. It is the third video in this series. In the first two videos, we have discussed about an overview of An Apology for Poetry. And in the second one, we have discussed various kinds of poetry as these have been depicted in An Apology for Poetry. So now let us discuss his views on drama. So, before going to understand the views of Sidney regarding drama, it is essential to understand the criticism of English drama at the period of Renaissance when Sidney was observing all these things. So, Sidney has also expressed his concern about the pathetic state of poetry in England towards the conclusion of his book An Apology for Poetry. He uses the term poetry in its original Greek sense, which represent not only poetry but all sorts of imaginative literature including drama. So whenever Sidney is saying poetry, it automatically includes drama. During the Renaissance in England, Stephen Gosson ranked poets and playwrights among mountebanks, which means the fraud or deceitful persons. So previously I also told you that Stephen Gosson attacked poetry and drama, and he levied a number of charges against poetry which were defended by Sidney. And here he is abusing poets and calling them, or degrading poet and calling them mountebanks, which means the fraud or deceitful performers. It was a kind of abuse, obviously, and it was not acceptable to Sidney because he himself was a poet. He equates poetry and drama to cheap tricks. He says that the poetry and drama are used by the poets and dramatists as the cheap tricks with the help of which they deceive and corrupt the audience. Sidney was against all this, and that is why he has expressed his resentment towards the criticism of English drama. Now come to Sidney's views. Sidney himself analyzed the condition of contemporary English drama and accepted that obviously the condition is quite pitiable. And on what basis he said that, we would learn here. His ideas are largely influenced by classical theories, especially those of Aristotle. It is well known to you that Sidney was very much influenced by Aristotle. And specifically with reference to drama, he talks about the importance of dramatic structure that should be followed by the dramatist. And he also talks about the moral purpose of drama. So he analyzes the contemporary English drama on these two things, whether the dramatists are following the dramatic structure or the dramas are written with a moral purpose. He strongly criticizes failure of English dramatists to adhere to the classical standards. He came to the conclusion that neither they are following the strict dramatic structure as it has been suggested by Aristotle, and the dramas are not written specifically for moral upliftment of the audience. He accepts the poetical decadence and the tendency of the English poet to write uninspired writing in vita minerva. So he accepts the thing that poets are not following the structure, and whatever they are writing according to their own, they are writing it according to their own wish. Their writings are uninspired. It means they are not taking inspiration from the classical model. This thing he described as in vita minerva. It is a kind, Minerva is a Roman goddess and it is a Roman phrase, and Minerva is considered to be the goddess of wisdom, art and talent, and as the poetry has been described as uninspired, it means they are not taking inspiration from Minerva as it has been taken by the ancient Roman poets. So their writings are uninspired, that is why they are not capable of reaching to the moral purpose or the purpose of the drama. He favors to follow classical model of drama writing. So now what structure or what rules Aristotle is talking about in his Poetics? Sidney wants that these rules should also be accepted or used by the contemporary dramatist. Like a classicist, Sidney emphasizes importance of Aristotle's concept of unity. Unities, this is unity of time, unity of place and unity of action for dramatic structure. So the dramatic structure should maintain these unities. I think you must have an idea regarding that. The unity of time, it means the span that is going to be presented on the stage should not be more of 24 hours, and there should be a single location and there should be a single action. He criticizes many plays of his time by English playwrights for these things, that they are not observing unities. They are having the disjoint plots, so that is why locations are changing. They spanned over long period. It means that the rule of 24 hours has not been maintained and multiple locations they are using. And that is why the contemporary dramatists are not following the Aristotle's concept of unity. Sidney believes that such disregard for structure of drama lessens its emotional and moral impact. It means the purpose of drama fails, as neither it is affecting the audience emotionally nor it is having any moral impact on the audience. Sidney views drama, like all poetry, as having the moral purpose. So how the moral purpose of tragedy is fulfilled? It has also been described by Aristotle by evoking the feelings of pity and fear that ultimately leads to catharsis. And the process of catharsis further moves the audience towards a deeper understanding of virtue and human frailty. So audience automatically learns something from the tragedy, and whole of the process of catharsis continues, and ultimately the audience has a deeper understanding of virtue and human frailty. He stresses the aim of drama is not just to entertain but to teach moral lesson through emotionally powerful stories. But what was going on in those days? The stories were not emotionally powerful. That is why they could not teach the moral lesson. So it has been accepted by Sidney. Such a purpose he finds missing in contemporary drama, as these were mainly concerned with entertainment. Contemporary drama, the main emphasis was there on the entertainment. Tragedy and comedy as distinct genre. Aristotle argues that tragic and comic elements should not be mixed together, because they are the distinct genres with different structures, purposes and emotional impact, and these should not be mixed, as mixing of these could dilute the emotional power of tragedy and humorous intent of comedy. It means if we are mixing together both tragic and comic, they would stand nowhere, because the purpose of tragedy would fail, because there is the dilution of emotional power of tragedy, and the purpose of comedy would also fail because humorous intent of comedy would get lessened. And in that way, both comedy and tragedy would not be able to achieve its purpose. Sidney acknowledges the value of comedy, and he says that comedy offers light entertainment by exposing human follies, though he insists that a comedy should be refined and should not degenerate into vulgarity. favors tragedy because tragedy could perform a greater moral purpose of elevating the soul through the depiction of the great moral struggles and consequences of the human flaws. So in a tragedy, we see the fall of a hero. We see the moral struggles of the hero. When the audience sees or observes the moral struggles of the hero, the audience automatically learns some lesson that the consequences of human weakness may be like this. They adopt it. They learn the lesson that this may also happen in their life. So Sidney has accepted that English plays fail to follow classical models and often features improbable plots. It means their plot structure is not good, the focus is not there, and there is blending of tones. It means comic and tragic are going to be mixed in the contemporary drama, and that is why the dramas are not effective. Sidney accepted it. But in spite of this criticism, Shelley defends drama from its Puritan detractors, means Puritan critics, who condemn the theater as immoral. Critics like Stephen Gosson had condemned the theater as immoral. Sidney was not accepting that fact. Sidney argues that drama, when properly constructed, it means when the due emphasis is given to the structure of drama, then it can be both morally instructive and emotionally engaging. It would fulfill the purpose of entertainment and moral education if it is properly constructed, if proper attention is paid to the structure of the drama. Then it can move audiences and inspire virtue, thus serving a noble purpose. Sidney was of the opinion that drama in itself is not bad or immoral as a genre. It means the evil is not in the genre. The evil is not in drama or poetry. Rather, the evil is there in the playwrights as they are not following the models properly, as they are not capable of using it in a proper manner. So in this manner, he defended drama, not the dramatist. So I think you would be able to understand the defense of drama by Sidney and his views on drama. So thanks for your patience listening.